Germany's Rheinmetall has unveiled its first new battle tank since the 1970s, the KF51 Panther. It's the successor to the Cold War origin Leopard and Leopard II tank. Rheinmetall has been speculated to be working on a new tank since at least 2014 to 2015. The project gained urgency after Russia showcased the T-14 Armata next generation tank. Like the T-14, the Panther threatens to disrupt the status quo in the West and Russia, where conservative investments on both sides have meant no party is willing to invest heavily in a new 21st century design in order to reduce expenses. Rheinmetall states that the number of design innovations in the KF-51 address the weakness of current tanks. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes what makes Rheinmetall KF-51 Panther main battle tank a formidable platform. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. The tank has greater strategic and tactical mobility than existing Western designs. Its weight of just 59 tons means it's much lighter than Leopard 2 at 66.5 tons and Abrams M1A2 at 66.8 tons. The reduced weight will make it easier to transport to the theater of war where it's needed. Panther also fits the tunnel profile AMOVP-4L without preparation, a requirement that no current MBT fulfills. Confirmation to NATO's AMOVP-4L profile means it can navigate roads, bridges, and tunnels that may not be accessible to larger tanks. It has a range of around 500 kilometers or 310 miles. The tank features a new main cannon. Where 125mm guns arm most modern Russian, Chinese, and North Korean tanks, with the T-14 expected to integrate a 152mm gun in the future, the Panther has been upgunned from the NATO standard 120mm to a 130mm gun, the Rheinmetall Future Gun System. The Panther's gun has been marketed as being more than 50% more effective than the Leopard 2s and offering a much longer range while being able to fire both kinetic energy sabreted projectiles and a range of programmable explosive ammunition types. It also has a 12.7mm coaxial machine gun. An optional remote-controlled weapon station will allow it to deploy loitering ammunition, drones, missiles, and possibly even defensive anti-aircraft weapons, depending on how the tank is configured. The optional Hero 120 loitering ammunition capability expands the Panther's strike capability to non-line-of-sight targets and can be mounted depending on role and mission requirements. Hero 120 carries a 4.5kg or 10 pounds warhead, has an endurance of 60 minutes, and a range of 60 kilometers or 37 miles. The Panther is designed to control assigned unmanned aerial vehicles, such as onboard or offboard drones, loitering ammunition, and a range of uncrewed ground vehicles. As per Rheinmetall, All weapons are connected with targeting sights, and the fire control computer, through the fully digitized architecture, allowing for hunter-killer and killer-killer operation, seamless target engagements, and future AI decision support. The Panther benefits from greater protection than the latest Leopard 2 variants without compromising its weight. It integrates a top attack protection system, TAPS, the Rosy Smoke Obscurant system, and digital NGVA architecture, facilitating the employment of sensors to detect launch signatures and thus better respond to threats. The top attack protection system is especially important since most current tanks have been found to be vulnerable to top attacks, where protection is generally much weaker. For example, UK Army's Next Generation Light Anti-Tank Weapon, NLAW, has a dedicated top attack mode. The Panther further integrates the Rheinmetall Strike Shield Active Protection System. Strike Shield Active Protection System is based on the hard kill principle that neutralizes ballistic threats before they reach their intended target. The passive protection comprises ballistic protection, mine protection, IED protection, fighting compartment protection, transparent protection, signature protection, protection from shape charges, spall liner, standalone armor, and add-on armor. The Panther is also fully cyber-hardened. According to Rheinmetall, Panther is a truly software-defined tank, fully enabled to collect and disseminate information on the multi-domain battlefield. Deep integration of modern BMS and software-defined communication systems enables forces to operate in collaborative combat environments, such as cross-platform sensor-to-shooter links. This provides exceptional situational awareness. The fully digitized system and common crew stations are the enablers for true human-machine teaming and control of wingman UGVs that cover capabilities such as platoon-level air and drone defense. The Panther accommodates a crew of three, supporting future force structures with reduced numbers of soldiers. Two crew stations are located in the chassis, with one dedicated to the driver, and an optional station dedicated to a company commander, a drone operator, or a wingman pilot. The fully digitized NGVA architecture allows for seamless sensor and effector integration both within the platform and cross-platform. Sensor and weapon control assignments can be passed between crew members instantly. Each workstation can hand over and take over tasks and roles from others with no reduction of functionality, providing excellent flexibility. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.